This is WCPO 9 News.
Thank you so much for joining us for WCPO 9 News. I'm Craig McKee. Here's a look at some of today's top stories. Kentucky Governor Andy Beshear says the Commonwealth's fight against COVID-19 is a success story. Beshear says that's because state leaders put science ahead of politics. Nearly all pandemic restrictions were lifted in Kentucky on Friday. Beshear expressed frustration that mask mandates meant to slow the virus's spread became a question of liberty. Ohio Governor Mike DeWine says he feels, quote, very, very good, unquote, about his chances of being reelected next year. DeWine's comments come the day after former Congressman Jim Renacci announced that he is challenging DeWine in the GOP primary. DeWine disputed Renacci's suggestion that his virus response prioritized, quote, fear over freedom. He said it was informed, collaborative, and careful, and saved lives. A farmer from Winchester, Joe Blystone, is also running in the Republican primary. Well, after about a year now, crews are now repainting the Black Lives Matter street mural in front of Cincinnati City Hall. You can expect some traffic impacts from the work being done there between 9th Street and 8th Street. It's all shut down, and Plum Street will remain closed until Monday, the 21st. Each letter of the mural was designed by a different local black artist. Happening today, the grand opening of the revitalized Court Street Plaza downtown. Court Street hasn't been renovated in 33 years, and construction on the area began last fall. The nearly $6 million project flips Court Street into a festival-style street, and car traffic will move to one side, opening up the plaza to pedestrian traffic there. There are events planned on the new plaza through the weekend, including a ribbon cutting tomorrow and a classic car cruise on Sunday.
Hi there, I'm Chief Meteorologist Steve Raleigh. Good morning. As we look at your Saturday forecast, we're going to see mostly sunny skies. We're going to be pushing near 90 degrees in most neighborhoods. There's a slight chance of a shower, but it would be one or two that pop because of the humidity in the afternoon. For tomorrow, though, there's going to be a cold front that moves through. It'll be generally dry, but it might act as a trigger. And with the extra clouds, I'm going to keep the temperature at 85. Another front on Monday at 85 degrees, but it cools us down next week.